Welcome, ladies and gentlemen. It's day two here at DreamHack Bucharest, and we are just about ready to head into the first game. We're finally in best of three territory, Mantis. How do you feel about that?
Excited, man. I mean, we effectively got a best of three yesterday, I guess you could say, in terms of rounds. It was a long, grueling marathon, which Envious narrowly lost, I think it's safe to say. So I'm curious how they're going to bounce back today. You know, you saw Kenny S, very emotional at the end of it. Obviously, the rest of the team would have been feeling fantastic, but this is their chance to make amends now.
It definitely is. And, you know, they have to be the favorites. Both the analysts there predicting that Envy would take it 2-0. I didn't sense sort of an overwhelming confidence. It wasn't, this will be a quick, clean 2-0. And I've got to agree. I think 2-0 is the more likely scoreline, but I could see them both maps being fairly close here.
Yeah, I definitely agree with that. I think if we went back in time, then Envious would be firm favorites on Cobblestone and Cash, but things have changed quite a bit since then. Recent memory, though, in recent time, they've been dominant on Cash. They're actually 7-0 over the last 3 months, and that's including wins like 16-6 against FaZe, 16-8 against VP. So on Cash, I think Envious will be firm favorites. But I agree with the desk. I think Cobblestone is maybe where Gambit could take us to Nuke. And then Nuke, neither team really has that many games to go off. It's really hard to call on that map.
I mean, I obviously hope we're going to end up at Nuke just because I really like that map. And I'm hoping to see more of it. But it is going to be Cobblestone starting off first with Gambit now on the CT side. And Envy, they're going to be playing the terrorist side here early on. A big stack towards the B bomb site. Mo in charge of covering middle, and he's going to spot up so many people. I'm so glad he falls back already. It looked like he wanted to go and re-peek, and that's absolute suicide. So just play the angles and play defensively. There's no point in fighting that many people all on your own, especially in a big round like this one.
Definitely not. We'll be trying to relocate, see what they can get done. But the head's back together again, and we did see yesterday on Cobblestone, by and large, the pistol rounds went to A as well. And that's going to be Mo getting flashbanged, having to back away just below Balcony. He's going to be by himself with the smokes and flashes that have been expended between the two teams. Devils with two kills. Mr. Consistent of yesterday seemingly landing those frags. And man, he was a determining factor for Envious to even get into overtime.
Yeah, which is so surprising to have to say, but he was playing very well. And there's a third headshot coming through on Doge. He's finally going to go down, but you've got to think it's way, way too late here. Spaced 1-on-4. He's going to get another nice headshot, but it doesn't really matter any longer. And we already know this round is won, and it's pretty much all thanks to Devil. And I think also partly thanks to Gambit, just in spite of getting the early information, not actually adjusting all that well to it. As soon as Mo realizes he saw at least two people and probably three when he made that first peek in the doorways, and there weren't that much movement on the other side of the map. You know, someone could have moved, I think, a little bit closer. They were actually allowed to run past the truck to get the kill on Mo without there being any assistance there at all. And that's almost unforgivable, I think, for Gambit.
Yeah, that is definitely a lapse in concentration. And we spoke as well about how Envious typically are a team that starts a bit slow at the gates. They definitely did yesterday. So Gambit starting strong on Cobblestone could be all the difference. Spaze did manage to save himself a smoke and a kit. So that gives him a little bit more power going through into this round alongside the 5-7. CZ's across the board. And Kenny S will be taking point with MAC-10. He's going to get traded, Mo, for him. And now as Hooch is going to be next to fall afterwards. Apex with the entry frags, as expected, and getting a lot of money in the bank as well. That's MAC-10 frags across the board.
Not a bad way to set up a round here. Gambit probably hoping to trade a little bit more effectively just so they could maybe steal a rifle somewhere, maybe do some damage. They have bought armor as well into this round, so they're definitely looking for more than just the one kill here. Adrian is playing close to drop and right on the other side, happy, ready and waiting.
Adrian in a precarious position, although Doja will get him in the back for happy. So that is a MAC-10 that's been picked up now. No easy frags. Head armor on everybody on Envious, as you'd expect in this kind of situation. But at this point, Gambit have a decision to make. Do they want to go for this? They have the kit that was saved from Spaze in the last round, but they need to get the frag. And that kit has now been dropped. So instead, Doja decides, just going to save this. Take it away. Could even drop the CZ to somebody else and have two players that have a bit of an upgraded arsenal coming through into round three, because apart from that, it's effectively going to be a save.
Yeah, I mean, this is a solid choice and a fairly sort of fundamental one. So going into the third round, Envy, I don't think they're going to be too upset. They mainly had SMGs and they managed to save the AK there on Devil. So I think they're going to be in a decent position. Doja not even able to save the MAC-10. So Overall, a good start for Envy, and we do expect them to pick up a bunch of rounds here on the T side. Gambit are the ones that are going to have to really show us what they can do on CT side.
That's very true. And of course, on the CT side of Cobblestone, that economy is so, so sketchy. Back and forth, three SMGs, MBK with the CZ. So really, it's just Devil that has a great deal to lose in this round. But obviously, Gambit not able to save anything going through. They're going to be on full pistols, no Kevlar, nothing else. And Happy's going to use this advantage to try and push his way around the back of A and just clear this out for the rest of his team. It is a stack on B. I like what Gambit have gone for. It's not going to pay off this time around, though.
Yeah, and again, it's so common to see people using these SMGs just to sort of scout around with. Even if Happy had somehow got caught there, it would have been a minimal loss. And as a result, instead, they clear out the entire A-bomb site, and they pretty much know exactly where Gambit are right now. So it shouldn't be a problem to just close out this round without too many casualties. Happy does kind of go down there, but apart from that, it shouldn't be too bad.
Absolutely not. Expendable weapons. You probably don't want a great deal of SMGs going against M4s in the next round anyway, so it's totally fine to just go out and try and get as many kills and as much money on the board as possible. Apex the next. Almost caught in two mines. I think he picked up the first frag straight away. He will go down. MBK next up with the MP7. He falls. But again, as we mentioned, no big deal for Envious. They're going to have AKs in the next round regardless.
Mo's got a double kill, and he's actually going to go for the pre-fire. Oh, that should... Oh, it's a team kill, in fact.
Wow.
Devil now going to be alone. That was very confusing. So costing a little bit. At least it's not the massive penalty that it used to be.
Yeah.
Losing, what was it, $1,500, I think, and now it's down to $300. So it's not too bad, but really still a pretty good round for Gambit. They managed to do some damage. I mean, at least forcing them to rebuy some grenades, some Kevlar here, and some rifles as well. So we'll see how that goes.
Devil just executes him in the back of the head. But as you said, yeah, honestly, Gambit came into that round with just one P250. That was it. The rest of them had USPs, no nades. So really not a bad round. Mach 10 for a Dren.
A little bit dangerous. Spaze early on. Just one simple flashbang. That's all he needed. And he picks up the kill, goes back into a little bit more of a defensive position. He's still got some backup here. Not necessarily a bad position, but the flashbang's coming out. Just can't see a thing. And now he's trapped in that corner and needs some help.
Spaze, of course, the player that got a couple of clutches last time around. It's going to be up to him to try and rain down some fire. And indeed he will. Two frags, flawless round for Gambit. Welcome to the scoreboard, keeping all their weapons intact.
That's a bit unnerving. That was a very solid round. I mean, that first kill, just with the flashbang, you'd think that they would... They had three people on the other side. Even if they were just blind shooting at the angle, he'd be in trouble. So, a little bit sketchy, perhaps. Envy letting go of a round and actually immediately falling back to Tech Nines and one deagle here. So, that's a big reset.
Yeah, I was a bit curious on the decision because Spaze actually picked up the orb initially and then dropped it for an M4. I don't know if that was accidental or on purpose, calling that maybe the pistols would be coming in. That's where the AWP could struggle a little bit, but regardless, it's going to be full assault rifles. And Envy is playing this one fairly slow to start off with. Of course, they will have a solid buy in the next round. So any kills on a bomb plant, and they're pretty much happy with this result.
I'm really wondering why they didn't go for a buy this round. Just looking at the economy, they could have had, I think, two AKs and a little bit more, but what a shot to start off with here. NBK going to be taking down Hooch. And not necessarily a good start for Gambit. Now they're following up with the Tech-9s running in here. Good shot from Adrian, but he's still going to get overwhelmed. Kenny picking up the kill. Doja with the reply as well. It's still a 2-on-3, and Doja out in the middle of nowhere, leaving it all to Spaze.
What a one dig to kick the round off. And now Envious, maybe they had so much supreme confidence in themselves. They didn't need assault rifles. Spaze did land that shot while jumping. That's pretty filthy, and he gets punished. 4-1, Envious from strength to strength.
And those involuntary jumps, I really wonder about those. Like, is he sort of hitting his mouse into his teammate's keyboard or anything like that? Because you can tell he did not want to do that. A little bit scary. Gambit are able to buy, and partially because that round that they won, they had everyone surviving. Otherwise, they would have been ecoing now. So Envy finding just a big round win here. They're going to be excited about that one.
Yeah, Gambit struggling a little bit. Hooch currently yet to get a frag or an assist. 004 needs to change for Gambit, who have gone in for a bye this round. It's not going to be great, though. Curious to see if Space is going to get more help, because it really was him yesterday. Now, I think he got two clutches almost back-to-back, which were absolutely ridiculous, that kept Gambit in the game a little while longer. So we know this guy's capable of playing solid Counter-Strike on Cobblestone.
It's a weird position here. Going to be simply Molotov'd out in the corner, and NBK headshot on Adrian as well. But even the initial setup was one that was going to be really tough to make work. So wondering what the plan was. FaZe picking up a good one, and the second one as well, going for a third. Could have been NBK. Look how low he is. So still a 2-on-3. It is possible here, but this position for Happy is incredible.
Yeah, really solid. The only downside for him is he's got an MP7, but if he catches them from behind, it's not going to matter. Or maybe just jumping up onto the window ledge. Connecting the headshot. Mo getting tagged up through the doors. Needs to back away. There's no hope of getting this round clutched. But he knows that Happy's somewhere over this side of the map, so he has to be very careful. He can see him checking every corner.
Really trying to save this AWP. See if he's going to be able to. It would be great for them going into the next round. They're going to have no money at all, so just the solitary sniper could still do a lot of damage to the Envy team. But some really weird rounds here. I mean, that kind of a beginning from NBK, who also closes out the round with a quad kill there. You'd think that would be sort of smooth sailing. Space almost brought it back, and then the initial setup there, that corner that Hooch was in, is so dangerous.
Yeah, it's brutal, but you can see that Space trying his best again to just hold this off by himself. Those two frags gave them a glimmer of hope, but it was quickly shut away again. And now Gambit, not for the first time, USPs. This time Space, as a result of him being top fragger for his team, he's got 9 kills, more than double anyone else on his team. He's actually got more frags than the rest of his team put together. So he's able to afford the investment of a Deagle and see if he can get some work done.
That's so painful to think about. Still early days here on Cobblestone in the first half, but you gotta hope that will change soon enough. Already down is Doja, and Space does have a Deagle, so maybe he could make something work. He's actually gonna be going down fairly quickly here, and NBK holding his own. And that's going to make it 6-1 in favor of Envy. Top fragging on their team is NBK with 8-1-3, so that's a fairly good ratio as well. And we'll see if they can make anything work here, Gambit. They really, really need to start putting some more rounds on the board, especially because Envy's economy, it hasn't really exploded yet, but we're at the point where if they win just another couple of rounds, then they'll just have almost infinite money.
And back into another precarious round where they have the M4s, no kits, though, and a lack of grenades. And Envy's haven't necessarily been playing explosive T rounds so far. They've been taking their time. So I do wonder as to how many grenades Gambit will have left once the onslaught does come to fruition. They've already used plenty of them. They've got 3 flashes and a smoke, and there's a minute and 25 or thereabouts to play with. Someone needs to start landing some shots here for Gambit.
Space, he's playing a dangerous game right now. There is not much backup in case he gets caught out here. I mean, Adrenaline's behind him on the stairwell, but if the angle is right, then he can't even do anything about that. While the rest of Envy right now, everyone except Happy, pushing towards danger over here, trying to see if they can maybe find a way to get in. Mo in a great position up on the wall, and this time they got, I think, a better setup than last time.
Yeah, it looks solid, but you can see the flashes, and they check it instantly. The pop flash wrecking Mo. Space is good for one. Here comes Hooch with his first kill. Is this going to be the curse lifted? No, he gets picked off straight away. Adren now next up to see if he can get some work done, but he's going to have to face off against 2 angry terrorists. And now Space does come in from the other side, but he's so low on health. One stray bullet and he's a dead man. There's the frag though, looking to transfer the spray, and Kenny S gets the better of him. With 64 health left, Envious moved to a 7-1 lead.
How does Hooch not almost instantly get that second kill? And whoever it was come running out of the doorway and onto the slope there, they failed to kill MBK for a while. There was so many really weird fights that could have gone Gambit's way and just didn't. It was an expensive round for Envy, but it's much worse for Gambit. Again, they're back to pistols here. I really feel like they've had a lot of opportunities so far, Gambit, that they haven't converted into anything. And that's going to be a problem.
I completely agree. It's not been a game where they've just been totally shut out, so that's going to do their confidence quite a bit of damage. Apex, in the meanwhile, reading the economic situation perfectly with the MAC-10. Lands himself a quick fire triple kill. Adren now, last player left. He's been spotted, and Apex will secure his quad. We've had so many quad kills, by the way, that we've casted. I think the stat was like there was 6 or 7 quad kills on Mirage yesterday.
Yeah, like. And like a bunch of them were from Apex, actually.
Yeah. Yeah. Just,
maybe someone can dig up his stats on quad kills for this tournament, because he's got to be shooting up there right now. 8-1 as well. Envy, they are in such a good position. You said earlier Space has as many kills as his entire team combined. Well, that's still true, yeah. Which, I mean, is terrifying for him, obviously. If just anyone else in any of these close rounds had landed one more kill, then it could have worked out, but it seems like he has just a lot of work to do. He's actually top fragging in spite of the fact that there's 7 rounds behind. He's one kill ahead of Apex still.
He's been doing a great job on the A side. He's been holding it down towards headshot and down mid. But there's only so much one person can do on the CT side of Cobblestone, as he's finding out the hard way. He's on 12 and the rest of his team's on 11, by the way, as Anders was mentioning just before. So, I mean, that is the terror, right? And that's matchmaking levels of terror.
You really don't want to be carrying that hard, especially when you're just a couple of kills short of winning the rounds. Happy almost sneaking his way into a kill on Space. Mo going to be picking up NBK, so a little bit of help being given here, and that is definitely going to be good. A nice start for them, and second kill coming in on Kenny. Mo really stepping it up, and I think the very fact that they sort of engaged with Happy over at the other side, that's almost an indication that something is up, because Happy does play a lot alone on this team.
Yeah, he does. And we started to see that yesterday on Mirage. Originally, he was sort of the designated lurker, then Devil started to take it over more. So, curious to see how this one plays out. Mo as well, it should be mentioned, against VP, was very quiet until he got the AWP in his hands. And that's where things started to get a bit crazy. He's been picked off. There's Dozier and Adren as well, picking up kills. Apex, last terrorist remaining. Nearly lands the shot, but his days surely are numbered, especially considering there's 10 seconds left. So, best case scenario is to save the AWP. Unlucky timing.
Yeah, and I mean, I think in that case, because they knew where he was, trying to stay alive could have been dangerous as well. So kind of good that he died at least before the clock ran down. They will be able to save the sniper on the Gambit side, and we are going to be at 8-2. So moving into the 11th round, it's pretty much now or never. I feel like Gambit need a solid 6 rounds in the first half here. So they need to start stringing together a bunch of rounds right now.
Oh, for sure. And they're not going to get much better opportunities than right here, right now, either. Now they have double AWPs in play. Dren with the second. And mixing it up as a result. Space, who's been playing a lot on A, now finds himself going over to long B. 3 players around this. Pretty standard setup right now. Nothing out of the ordinary for either team. A lot more nades on the side of the terrorists, though. Just 1 incendiary left, 1 HE. The CTs to play with.
See if they could build something off of that. The clock is still over a minute left here, so they should be just fine. But now Apex going in first, which is his role, looking for those entries and having a fight with Doja. Not really connecting just yet, and there are 2 people on the other side. This is a really long battle here in drop where no one gets a kill. And finally, great pop flash coming through, and a second headshot, shutting down Space. Apex, a third one as well, dropping Hooch, and that's going to leave Mo all on his own. So it took a while to get started, but once it did, there was really no stopping Apex, it seemed. And Gambit, the worst possible scenario here, getting reset right after that win again.
Apex is so, so difficult to contend with when he's on this kind of form with his entry fragging, and Gambit have nothing to answer back. And Mo's gonna land too, but he's not gonna get the round. And that's the important part. Envious will break the economy once more. And Gambit, I mean, they're in a terrifying position at this point. This is going to quickly slip away.
One more quad kill for Apex. I hope someone is keeping a count or a score out there, because it is getting pretty high at the moment. That puts him at 15 overall in starting just now in the 12th round. It's pretty impressive.
That second kill is pretty disgusting. Just the flick, the one-tap flick from above.
Here's what really bothers me is that Gambit, because that fight goes on for so long, what worries me is not so much. I mean, you can't really account for the idea that he would get a triple kill. But when they wait that long, they're at risk of getting pushed from the plateau as well. So I feel like at that point, they should be the ones to take the initiative and say, let's pop flash our way into drop and let's go and actually find the kill on him instead. feel like they gave too much time for that. Good shot from Hooch here, but still, just pistols.
It's the same problem we saw them against VP yesterday on Cobblestone, where they just didn't seem to really change things up. They didn't seem to adapt to the situation at hand. Just played fairly standard stuff and just got them battered. You've got an AK to play with in this round, but I feel like, especially with the bomb being planted, this should surely just be saved. So Gambit again going to be conceding this round to put them already in an 8-round deficit. And the best case scenario for this half is going to be 5 rounds on their CT side. That would still be doable, but very difficult.
It could definitely be done, but I am worried as well. And even the upcoming round, you know, the round loss bonus is not that great. They're still going to struggle to put together any kind of really good buy here. So I would definitely be worried if I was Gambit right now. It is the first map, but all of the analysts seem to agree that if there is going to be a map that they could win, it's probably this one if they want to push it onto Nuke. Good shot for Mo. Oh, and a great follow-up. Apex and Devil just out of it.
Yeah, because if we go through to cash, there's a reason why I think the analysts and myself, and I'm assuming you as well, would agree that this is their chance as opposed to cash. They've beaten VP twice, FaZe, Flipside, and Complexity, all fairly convincingly. The most rounds they've lost in recent memory has been 11 against VP.
It's too early in the morning for me to have any real opinions on anything. I just kind of go with the flow this early on.
Chilling laid back, I like
only,
it.
Only my body is really awake. Mine is still in hibernation somewhere. They have gone for a fairly large stack over at the B-bomb site, leaving Hooch alone with the stolen AK over at the A side, and he's playing, I think a position that most people like to play when they're playing alone over here, just sort of covering a little bit of everything. We'll see if Envy are going to walk into to anything over at B. They are playing all of these rounds very slowly, and it's working, so you can't really blame them.
Well, yeah, if it ain't broke, don't fix it. Gambit don't seem to be able to deal with this very well. We haven't seen them play too aggressively by forcing a way through mid, as we saw Snax do against Gambit yesterday. Very cheekily pushing mid a couple times on CT side. Doshri is going to get the trade in his favor, at least for now. And this allows now a player to flank around the back of them. But if Envy is executed quickly, it may not end up mattering. The Mag 7 goes in, gets taken out straight away from MBK. Happy, meanwhile, is going to try and hold down the fort in the smoke. But the rest of the action is ensuing elsewhere on the site. Mo's going to go down next, and that's probably the hopes and dreams of Gambit fading away. And it was Hooch that was flanking, but therein lays the issue, Anders. If you have no team left on the site, the flank is basically useless.
I struggle to understand the part in the round where Doja gets the kill on drop, and then they decide, let's go aggressive on plateau. You know that if it's going to be a B split, which almost every attack to B is, then it's going to be split, drop, split, plateau, because that's almost the only option that exists, right? Good shot there from MBK. I mean, right now, Gambit just trying to make anything work. But in that round, surely when you defuse one arm of that attack, it's Doja very nearly. Maybe there could have been a second guy, but, you know, you almost certainly defused most of it. Then why sacrifice anyone onto the plateau? Just don't understand.
Maybe Gambit haven't quite woken up too. Too early in the morning for them. I'm not entirely sure, but this map has been a lot more one-sided than I assumed it would be. Still not quite over just yet, but certainly looking that way. Dren will at least get himself an AK-47 to save going through into the next round. What am I talking about, Anders?
I mean,
does it even matter?
I doubt it at this point. 11-2 right now, and bomb has only just gone down, so Envy really taken a long time. It's going to be a second AK picked up here. And at this rate, Gambit, if they could get a third round, if they could win the 15th round, still be very far behind. Winning the pistol then, maybe that would put them in like a, you know, 6-12 type scoreline. It's not impossible. It would be spectacular.
Yeah, it's like I'm almost scolding myself for being optimistic about this. I feel like this is pretty much a foregone conclusion at this stage, but fair play to Gambit for sticking in there. As you say, maybe a third round into a pistol, a 12-6, break the economy of Envious a couple times, then you start to breathe down the necks again, but there's so many what's, ifs, and buts before we get to that stage, and this is the first one. They've pretty much got to win this round.
Yeah, and it's it's a little bit stupid because some of the rounds that they end up losing, like they win that fourth round and they get eco'd. They lose to that early deagle shot from NBK and just get run down by Tech9s. And like both the rounds they've won have been very solid. The first one they lost nobody. The second one I think they lost one person. So they've been very convincing rounds. But then all the close rounds, all the sort of close situations have all gone in favor of Envy. And you just can't really win like that. You need some clutches every once in a while.
Absolutely. And then they've not been coming up. Space, who's the clutch king yesterday, not able to get anything done. Started very well. A trade going back and forth, another one, but this should favor the terrorists. It's just been right down to the wire again. A matter of seconds, it's now a 2v1. And Mo with his AWP just spotting the player hopping across the window. Knows it's going to be a B hit with a bomb. Still loads of time to play. We have no rush for Envious, but they're going to be planting for Kenny S behind the statue on the chicken coop and B alongside.
And how do you even get into this bomb site if you're Mo right now? You've got almost no chance to know where they're coming from. He walks in and it's going to be Kenny. Close out the half and make it 13-2 in favor of Envy. Incredibly decisive victory for them. In the end, Space did get some help from Mo. They end up at 12 and 11 kills. And on the other side, it's Apex and NBK doing the sort of majority of the work. But there's a lot more consistency on the Envy side. And Gambit, I feel like if they rewatch this demo, if they could bear it, if they have the heart for it, they're going to realize that there were at least a couple of opportunities. This could have been 5 or 6 rounds for them on the first half, and it just wasn't.
Yeah, and you're speaking of consistency. Space, who started lightning fast, and we even said at the time he had 12, the rest of his team had 11, finished with 12. So yeah. In the last 6 or 7 rounds, he got 0 kills. Absolutely no impact. And you can see how much that therefore made Gambit struggle.
It's really painful. It's also painful to imagine that the 2 rounds they got were so separate. You know, it's always better if you can obviously streak the rounds and have, you know, 2 in a row, but that just wasn't an option for them here. So 13-2 heading into the second half. If they win the pistol, it's going to be incredibly tough. If they don't win the pistol, I think they're just going to be put out of their misery real quick. It's going to be on to cash.
Yeah, it could be a mercy killing, honestly. Envious administering euthanasia. Because Gambit, I mean, they've been struggling here. There's no two ways about it, and I don't think it's going to get easier on cash. That's the other worrying thing. Devil hops up for a second before deciding against it. Just looking for the information. It will be a Dren by himself while the rest of his team starts to force their way onto A, but Envious haven't bit onto this. In actual fact, they're quickly rotating, and it's going to be Apex holding it down. 2 kills, looking for a third, but he's done the damage again. Gambit in a 2-1-4.
Space and Hooch left. I've got to say, Devil's been really stepping up in these pistol rounds. He's got double kill once again here. And this tournament has been great for him so far on the pistol front and pretty much on every front, it seems. Space once again find himself alone, but it's not going to matter. Kenny will take him out. And Envy now 2 rounds away from winning the first map here in a best of 3. I do want to point this out. This is really critical. They are 3 people coming. This is cap position. I almost wish we could freeze it here. Look at the time delay between Mo pushing out, because once he goes past the pillar there, Apex is actually in an awful position. It's so bad to be there when, if he got the shot midair, then that'd be fine. But as soon as he misses that kill, he's in a very bad position. But the rest of the teammates from Gambit, they're supposed to back up Mo. They take just long enough that Apex is able to fight them one at a time. That's not good enough. That can't happen.
Yeah, I mean, there's a term, revenge fragging, and you've got to make sure that the worst case scenario is a 1-for-1 trade, so you can just barrel onto the site. So I completely agree. And maybe that sums up Gambit's performance so far in a nutshell, just that one play. Apex, back to business. Does actually get bested from the hands of Mo with a Tech9, but 2 players already tagged up, actually 3. Mo's also fairly low. Devil comes in with the USP and puts him down. Kenny S with the M4 will do the rest. The bomb hasn't quite got onto the site just yet, so this is another rough ask for Gambit.
Yeah, I mean, if Doja had the bomb, then they could have put some pressure on Envy here, but it's going to be a little bit tricky. He does get a kill and actually jumps around the corner, does a lot of damage, and look at that. Doja picking up 2 more kills, making it a triple, leaving NBK alone. He's got a big chance of doing this. He's got the health for it, but he's going to crouch in. That is not a good idea, and Doja with a quad kill, giving Gambit a 3rd round. I sound excited, but, you know, ultimately, really, really matter here.
It's just your love of the game shining through, Anders. You know this is all Ogre at this point.
It's got to be, right? Maybe the potential for another, you know, for more overtime here.
I mean, it would be a similar position. They got, what, two rounds? I think it was 12-3 yesterday, wasn't
it? Yeah, it was.
So this would be even more of an epic comeback if they managed to pull it off. I'm not necessarily a believer just yet. Envious have no rush, but they have gone in for a commitment into this round with a deagle. Well, two deagles and five sevens. It is Envious after all. You kind of expect this.
Plus, when you're this far ahead, I feel like you know you've got so many rounds to play with. Which I always thought, oh my god, what is that? NBK, he did it on the terrorist side and he's just done it again, taking down Adrian. Kenny is hiding in the corner with the 5-7. He's got a distraction there to help him out as well. Devil is sort of playing for all of the attention, and that's an easy kill for Kenny. It's great teamwork.
Yeah, nicely done. But again, Gambit seem caught in two minds. They're kind of peeking one by one and getting picked off one by one. So sure, Envious still have a difficult task ahead of them with three assault rifles up against their pistols and MAC-10, but this is a lot closer than they would have been hoping for Gambit. Devil coming in from the doors. Meanwhile, there is going to be MBK who's lurking on the site itself with the Deagle. It's actually Kenny S, pardon me. MBK is coming from the other side. So what can Kenny do? He's got the 5-7 close range in space, lands the headshot. 3-on-1, but this isn't impossible by MBK standards.
Especially if they give him any chance here. And I think now that they know where he is, they're not going to peek it any longer. He's sort of hoping, he's really waiting for it, but there's no reason that they should. I'm kind of impressed that Space actually checked that corner that Kenny was in, because they saw one guy jumping off the balcony. They'd already got one kill in the A-bomb site. It's not clear that there would have been another person there. You've got to think about it as well. Kenny ran all the way from drop to that corner. So there's a good chance they could have had the count wrong, essentially, that they could have said, well, that must have been everyone on A, because we'd already seen like two people over at drop, so yeah, let's just go for it. So pretty well done. That's really, those are just important fundamentals, but they get overlooked fairly regularly. And that could have cost them the round if they hadn't.
Well, for sure. If Space doesn't check that at 5-7 at that kind of range, Kenny S definitely could have rounded up nicely. Even the bomb drop in a bad spot would have been a whole lot of issues for the terrorists. But Gambit now have brought it back to a 10-round deficit. Envious not really investing too much other than a P250 and a Deagle. A trend going for the spray, not going to land anything. There's Devil with the USP, actually breaking the deadlock into this round. What is happening for Gambit? Again, they've lost a lot of damage in a Dren. Doji's going to come with two frags. That alleviates a lot of the pressure that we're starting to stack, allowing Gambit now to maybe funnel out onto the B site. Pretty important trade, and Hooch will get the better of Devil finally.
And Doji even taking a third kill, so he seems to be really waking up. And just as I say that, he does kind of get knocked down by Happy, who really stood no chance at the end there. So overall, Gambit making up a little bit here, trying to make it work. Three rounds in a row. Now Envy are going to answer back in style. They got the AWP on Kenny. They have a fair amount of grenades. They got all the smokes they need, lacking some Molotovs, and interestingly lacking a defuse kit too.
Yeah, this is one of the ways the Gambit can start to slowly but surely get their way back into this, by keeping the economy of Envious constricted and keeping them at an arm's length. But the way they've been playing, like, Envious can definitely pull it off with this kind of weaponry. Hooch has already ate a fair chunk of his HP and damage. Kenny's going to have to use the smoke to extinguish his way out of there. He goes down by two-thirds nearly. So back and forth trade. Gambit stacking the majority of their plays over on the A side. And Doji will be taking point out, so it looks like they want to get a move on into this round.
He's allowed to walk really far up this ramp without anyone spotting him. So that in itself is a little bit interesting. We'll see if that's going to backfire on Envy. A lot of map control right now for Gambit. They do have the bomb over on Long as well, so it's going to be a really explosive round once it starts. And Happy goes down. He does trade first and gets Doja, but now Apex is in the back line here, and backup is miles away. He's going to have to get at least one kill, maybe more, and he gets absolutely nothing. Going to get taken out by Space. That leaves NBK, Devil, and Kenny. They might not even want to fight this. He's going to get the kill, Kenny, and just run away. And I think that's actually a solid choice for Envy. That's just Envy playing without any information on the A-bomb site. So as soon as the first trade happens, it's either Apex getting another quad kill or it's done.
Yeah, I like the fact they went back to save. That there could have been half a mind of, oh, we're so far ahead of them, you know, let's just throw caution to the wind, try and clutch. But just played by the numbers, played the smart side and try and save those weapons. And it allows them to get a decent purchase into the next round. They can probably drop a weapon or two across to the Apex and happy. May not be great weapons, may not be a great buy, but a whole lot better than nothing. Nice flick by Kenny. But round will go to Gambit. Looks like they're going to save all the three weapons as well.
It always upsets me when I see people in that sniper tower. Brings back really bad memories.
It's pretty tilting when you get killed from there, to be fair.
Because back in 1.6, people used to play, you know, free-for-all servers that would have, you know, 12 people on either team. And there would always be one or two people you had to find, you know, 10-minute round timer. It's a really long time to find people on Cobblestone in 1.6. Just never again, never again. Devil pushing out very aggressively. I love that. I think that's so incredibly cool. Huge props to Envy for trying that. It didn't work, but I almost don't care. I think that's just very refreshing and nice to see. I wish we saw more of that on Cobblestone, but it now they're kind of in a bad position because of it, but I don't care. I still think that was cool.
Yeah, I suppose this is one of those rounds where you definitely can throw it out there. You know, you've got a huge lead. They actually didn't invest into this round as much as I thought they would. I thought they'd drop a couple weapons, but they will have a buy into the next one. So why not try something crazy? This is what Gambit didn't do on their CT side. They played very static. They played very predictable and they got punished. So yeah, I'm alongside you. I think that was really cool. And Devil doesn't quite get the frag, but you can see his confidence as well, even going for that play. Like, this is the guy that's feeling it right now.
So is Spaze still hitting more shots here, and he's going to close out the round with a kill on Happy. That brings it to 7-14. And even then, even now, as we look at a pretty good streak coming in here, 5 rounds in a row for Gambit, we still feel like it's way too soon to start really believing in it. But one of the reasons why I think that aggressive push over there, I actually would like to see people do it even in regular rounds. Just because if you win the fight early on out here, the terrorist team will lose track of where the CTs are entirely. Like, think about how many places they could be in. They could lurk back into T-spawn and sort of, I mean, it's so hard to keep track of them once you lose the courtyard there. But it's obviously a huge risk and it didn't work out, but I still think it's a nice idea.
And the other cool thing is, this now keeps Gambit on the tiptoes. Will Devil do this again in the future? You can't take anything for granted. Will they try pushing up long? All these different aspects to it. So 14-7. I normally begin to believe in comebacks when a team hits the double-digit mark, when they get about 10 rounds. I think that's when I start to think, okay, this could become a reality. So there's still a little while to go yet for Gambit.
Happy that he wasn't hiding in that corner down there. Just realizing that would have been a bad move. Up on the wall, though, it could be great, especially with Apex distracting a lot over here. Molotov going to go up, but Gambit looks like they just want to try and see if they can make it through. Already pushing one guy in. Apex going to take care of Doja. And Happy, they still don't know he's up here. This position is so powerful right now. He should get at least one and preferably two. There's the one kill coming through. He actually falls back down into the open arms of Edren, but it doesn't matter. He still gets the kill. Space and Hooch get one in return each, and now it's a 1-on-2, and MBK going to end up winning it, putting it on map point here for Envy at 15-7.
Well, therein lays the issue with being so many rounds behind. You can put on 5 rounds in a row, but you still have 8 rounds to save to take us to overtime. And yeah, Happy played that one exquisitely. 2 kills.
And if you notice again, the first guy in from Gambit was quite a bit ahead of everyone else. Mm-hmm. To the point where they did get the kill on Apex, but I think that was mostly because he was fairly low. But there isn't much combined pressure, it feels like, for Gambit. Just more fundamental teamwork, I think, is what they need right now.
And that's going to have to be a whole lot more prevalent on Cash than on Cobblestone if they want to take down Envious there. Especially Kenny S is landing some nice shots. Cash, he can certainly be his playground. Cash is a map the Devil typically isn't too bad on as well, so a lot of things to watch out for. The MAC-7 point-blank range shot. Speaking of Devil, you will get one and get traded out.
And dropping Hooch from the round, who's at 21 kills, tied with Apex for the top frags. What a nice shot there. Apex actually trying to sort of safe peek down jump, but still was way too exposed and ends up going out of the round. So 3-4, and we'll see if they can make this round a win for themselves. They would need to win 8 consecutive rounds to push this into overtime. It feels very unlikely, but this round is looking great.
It is. You do still have 2 healthy Envious members left. Although they are on the opposite side of the map to where the bomb's about to get planted. I want to see how Envious move in here. Do they want to go for this or do they want to just save? Judging by the fact they haven't moved a muscle, it's going to be save. And there's the reason why. Their economy, not great. After five round losses in a row, they won one. They reset their unlost bonus and now they are effectively broken down. So keep these weapons in play.
I mean, such a tough ask right now. There is a sense in which when you're playing with your back against the wall like this, you sort of tend to really go all in, you know? Like, you know there's no saving, there's no riding the fence any longer. You just have to try for it. But, yeah, Gambit can't make any more mistakes. I feel like there's still just too much indecision going on that team.
Yeah, it seems like it. It's kind of like that fight or flight response, you know? Some teams maybe curl up and play even more passive and some just say, screw it, let's just go for it, let's go for broke. What they need is a few more sexy hair flips. I don't know if you saw that before, but we saw some pretty sexy hair flips.
I don't, but I'm sure I'll see it. I hope I'll see it on Reddit. But,
when on the desk, great. It just randomly showed on. It was beautiful.
Excellent, and wow, what a run boost here. Kenny, so dedicated to the cause, he's actually just dipping his knees in that fire, but not going to be too bad on him. Still, I kind of like the idea, you know, if all you've got is one AWP and one saved AK, maybe you could have got an early kill like that.
That is one way to definitely try and force the issue, to force the frag to go your way so that you can start to tip the scales in your favor. I like the idea. Envious mixing things up. Keeping it interesting. Mozo will put down Apex as he goes walkies in mid. Devil will meet the same fate alongside MPK, and this round will be starting to slip away. Happy with two, but it's not clean. He's down to 13 now. It's going to take something miraculous for him to get any more out of this situation. Actually nearly lands another frag as the flashbangs land, and now Kenny's came up from the backside. He's good for one kill. Can he flick on to a second? He did spot the second player, but he's not sure if he was down mid or went long side. And in the meanwhile, Hooch lands the headshot. Nine rounds now for Gambit.
That really does not inspire a lot of confidence when you almost lose that kind of situation there. Great play by Happy, but also a little bit questionable by Gambit. 9-15. They save both AWPs and are going to take them into this round where Envy really, again, don't have that much money to work with. So, is this doable? Do you believe in it, Mintz? Are you ready? Are you ready for more overtime?
I'm always ready for more overtime, but I unfortunately don't believe. I mean, yeah, they're probably getting to 10 rounds, but it's as you said, even when they're winning rounds against a fairly lackluster buy, they're still struggling, and so it doesn't really inspire confidence in me. How about yourself?
I'm a believer by nature, you know. Devil, it feels like he should be immune to fire with that name, but still gets the better of him. And again, can't expect too much out of this round for Envy. Happy has managed to get his way in behind enemy lines, and he's going to be running into the bomb, which is good fun. But he still actually goes down. It's a bit of a shame. Even if he had got the bomb, wouldn't have mattered. Yeah, I think the way I think about these situations is already how many buy rounds are left out of the next five rounds for Envy? Because obviously, I think if they were five straight rounds with AWP and M4s, I'd say 100% Envy win one of those five rounds. But that's obviously not going to be the case. They have one big buy here, but that depletes almost their entire bank. And they are just now getting, that's three rounds in a row. So their round loss bonus is still only building. So even if they do well this round, if they don't win it, they have to eco into the next one, or at least go for like a semi-buy or something like that. So it's possible. I think there's a road here, but Gambit needs to win some really critical rounds here.
I think at this point, you're looking at maybe two good buys and one decent buy in the last five rounds. So I would feel Envious should convert one of those.
Yeah.
I'd be very surprised if they didn't.
This is where the experience comes in, right? This is where you would hope that they can throw out a call here that sort of says, you know, this is something we feel confident in, we've had success with in the past, and let's just grind out one round. One single round to go up 1-0 here in the best of three and put them onto cash, which everyone agrees they're really good on. They should be walking away with a win there, because the one thing they don't want is to end up on nuke. just because of the lack of experience from pretty much all teams right now.
It's interesting as well to see the prior decisions have changed how Gambit are playing this round, as they're going to be playing one player up mid as we're speaking. Space has landed the first frag. Happy lurking again in the shadows, waiting for the right moment to strike, and he's found it. Down goes Doja. The bomb has gone to B, though, and will get planted momentarily. And MBK is not going to allow that to go down for free. Hooch lands the return headshot, but it is a 2-1-3. Make it a 2-1-2. Dren's pretty low, though, on 20 health, but he has the up, so it may not end up mattering.
No grenades at all left, though, for the Gambit side, and Envy at least have a few. Adrian here is going to survive the HE, and they don't have any more left, and now he's up on the plateau. What a headshot coming out. Adrian going for one more kill, but he's going to get outed. Happy taking that kill through the side of the box, and Hooch there to close out the round. Somehow Gambit staying alive. That round looked so good for Envy. They had such a fantastic start and a really great setup over at the A bomb side as well, and yeah, they can't really make it through.
At this point, Envy is like, not again. Come on.
Well, it's like the reverse, actually, of what it was yesterday. Because yesterday, they had the slowest start ever.
Yeah.
And then they sort of found their way. And this time, they've had a really hot start. They look so good. And I'm not sure if they've cooled off or if the rest of Gambit have just shown up. Because Doja and Mo and even Hooch and Dren, to some extent, are really starting to help out a fair bit here. So we'll see how it goes. Adren looking for the opening, and again, Envy without really any economy in this round, so they just have to go for the pistols here. It's a good spray and the Molotov as well. Lovely combo.
Well, choose the poison, bullets or fire.
Or both.
Why not? Burning while being shot. Sounds fun. MBK low, Devil dead. This is one of those rounds that certainly won't fall into the good or okay by category, so somewhat of a throwaway round. This next one will be another solid one. Envious from a position of, what was it, 14-7, 14-6, somewhere like that, to suddenly just a three-round deficit.
Yeah, I mean, they had two rounds going in from the first half, obviously, and now they're at 12, so that's just ridiculous. There is a phenomenon that's sort of been discovered or been documented a little bit here that future esports psychologists will probably, you know, marvel at. Which is this idea that once you get close, like once you get to 15-14, that's usually when you lose the game, because suddenly it's real, you know. Right now, Gambit are probably just throwing whatever they can at Envy, and it seems to be working. But once you get to that 14-15 stage, that's when suddenly you lose some confidence, or you focus too much almost. A quick trade early on in this round, and NBK almost taking a second kill with him.
Space is waking back up again with a frag, but it's being taken away courtesy of MBK's second kill. Mo has to save a 1v2 to keep Gambit in the first map of this best of three. There's the first one. It's all down to Apex now. He's landed so many quads on the T side. Is he going to be here on the CT side? There's still a minute to play with, so there's no rush for Mo. He can check every corner on his retreat. May even be thinking about trying to get over to where the A side. He misses his chance to get the frag and he's going to be trying to dart away. He's coming around back the other side of the concrete slab, and Apex misses his shot. It's so tense right now. Both teams on the edge of their seats, and the players ring around the tree. The spray comes out. Apex has missed so many bullets and gets picked off in midair. Mo somehow clutches. Apex is going to be distraught.
Oh, what did we just watch? I love the reaction from Apex. I think he knew that I think all of Apex movement in this 1v1 was really good. Like, especially right as the first kill happens and he's in a 1v1. The fact that he sneaks around the bomb side, like, it's just very, very smart play. But in the end, that was incredibly awkward. And that's going to give it 13-15. If they end up in overtime, we're all going to remember that 1v1. That's going to be a really big deciding factor. And again, it puts Envy back to pistols, as you were pointing out. Probably only have two good buys. They've really had one of them, and now things get very interesting.
I mean, we know Envious are an emotional team. They have players that definitely feed off emotion. How is that going to impact Apex, a man that they'll be definitely looking towards if it goes to overtime to perform miracles on the T side? That just bodied him mentally. This round, not expecting to get much out of it, so it's going to go down to the 30th again. Oh my goodness. Gambit have nearly pulled off a miracle.
That round, though, will feature a lot of firepower for Envy. It definitely will. They have the 3,400 loss bonus. They already have around 2,500 each in the bank, so they should have plenty of money going into that round. Kenny, not quite as sneaky as he thought he was, ends up getting found out, but MBK and Devil with some really good returns still should be a round that they can close out here. Gambit, surely not going to lose to just pistols. That would be horrific.
Be so anticlimactic, but Adresma trying to make sure that doesn't happen. Look where the bomb's been dropped. Happy can just sit here now. He may be a little bit worried if a player's coming around his right side, but Devil has his back covered. He's on balcony. He's been picked off now, and Gambit will dodge more bullets. We are going to the 30th round, but as you highlighted, it's going to be a solid buy. I'm not sure if they'll go for double ops. You've seen them go for double ops a couple of times. Are they going to go back into that again? Yes, they are.
That is the choice that they've gone for, and I mean, why not at this point here? They've got the money for it. They certainly are lacking some Molotovs, but I don't think that's really going to matter that much here. 30th round coming up, ladies and gentlemen, between Envy and Gambit. An absolutely incredible comeback so far from Gambit as they pull their way back from a 13-2 first half into a 14-15 scoreline. Apex over at Long, he's out. This is a huge off angle, and he's not going to get anything out of it. Four more kills, and we'll be in overtime here for Gambit.
This puts so much pressure on Happy's shoulders. He's now the lone A defender for a few more seconds. Devil is going to come with a frag. There comes Happy with one. Can't get a second. It was so close yet so far. And now the AK is going to be ripping through. Kenny had no idea that Dozier were pushing that aggressively. Where were the rest of the CTs? But they've kept this one close. It's now a 2-on-2.
Dozier pushing aggressively, maybe too much aggression there. Devil out in the open, he's gonna be going down, and now it's on NBK. He's behind the smoke, behind the fire, and in a 1-on-2, there's so much time. The bomb is gonna be going down here. Mo putting it down early on, and now NBK to try and clutch it. He's got a little bit of time. He's got the defuse kit and one smoke, so there's a slight and minuscule chance, but it's almost impossible. He sprays down one, spaces out of it, and again, it's Mo alone. 1-on-1 here, and NBK flashing out. That's actually a great flashbang, and he's up on the truck, looking over the wall here. Mo on the other side, NBK charging in, and there's the headshot. He's gonna clutch it. Envy win the first map. NBK top fragging on his team and carrying them onto cash.
And what were you saying before about the psychologist looking into the 15-14 choke? It was prevalent again, and there were chances for Gambit to win that round. They got a couple of huge picks on A site.
If you look at it, that 2v3, Dozier pushing in and trying to contest that hole in the wall just does not make it any sense at all. They knew they could get the bomb down. Mo was already on the site, so they could have had a bomb down, and Envy would have had to have found three people and a defuse. Those are the mistakes you, and again, I think that's where the sort of the psychology of it comes into play. That's when you start to feel like it's really happening, we can really go the distance, and then it fails. But what a run from Gambit. I feel like, I mean, if nothing else, they've certainly shown that they have something that's worth watching here. And think about how many rounds that were close in the first half. It could have been way more than two rounds for them on the CT side.
Oh, absolutely. If they get more rounds, they win the map. It's really that simple. And now we go through to Cash, a map that I really don't feel Gambit have too many hopes on. But who knows? After that comeback, I think anything's possible.
Yeah, it must have been exhausting to play for that long when you're Gambit, that kind of a comeback, and then don't follow through. You know, if you follow through, then obviously you've got a lot of energy. You know, you win in overtime, then you feel great. But when you put that much work into it and it doesn't really work, then that's going to be terrifying. So yeah, Cash, I think it's going to be one hell of an uphill battle. We will be ready with that after a quick commercial break. So stay with us and we'll be right back.